Hello and welcome back to Monmouth in Focus. Joining me right now, State Senator Joe Kyrillos. Senator Kyrillos, always a pleasure.
Cynthia, thank you. Great to be with you.
Thank you. Yeah. Let's talk about shared services at the state level. Such an important initiative, correct?
It's huge. We have super high property taxes in New Jersey, and there are a lot of reasons for it. We're a high-cost place. We have expensive schools. We have a school funding formula that sends an inordinate amount to certain school districts and less to others. But one of the reasons it's a high property tax state is we have an excessive amount of government. We have school boards and municipalities and authorities and utilities authorities, and it goes and goes and goes. And there's great duplication in all these governmental entities. And the towns are small. And of course, that may have made sense in revolutionary times, but if we were designing the map again, we would never design it this way. This patchwork of towns and counties that are very, very costly because of the duplication.
Sure, we have to change as times change, correct? And we know Monmouth County, the landscape has changed throughout the years, and you know, so has the entire state.
Well, we really do. We see what's going on in the private sector, and it's often very painful. But the private sector has to compete. They just can't go out there and raise more money. They've got to sell products, services, compete in a big, tough global economy. So they got to get lean, and they've got to get competitive. And so they find ways to collapse and achieve efficiencies and economies of scale. And now the public sector really needs to do that, not because it would be better make things, you know, a little bit more successful for the public out there, but because we have to. If we're going to be able to sustain ourselves and remain competitive as a state, localities able to make ends meet, particularly now with this new 2% property tax cap that the state has passed, towns and school boards are going to have to find ways to economize, achieve efficiencies, and do things smarter. I'm impressed with what Monmouth County is doing.
Senator, how challenging is it to get that message out?
Well, it's beginning to get out there, and it's challenging because people are ambivalent. On the one hand, they want lower property taxes. We all do. On the other hand, people like their small towns. They like to know who's on the police force, their cousins on the police force. You know, there's a lot of intimacy in New Jersey and in Monmouth County. But there's a lot we can do without losing that sense of character, of community. Freeholder Unknown is taking a great lead here in Monmouth County, and that really is where the lead should begin from a local point of view. The county is the overarching political entity for 50-plus municipalities, and it can and it is doing much more than other counties. Communicating to localities how we can collapse our services so we don't have tremendous duplication at every level of government. And I think over time, if we are clear with people and deliver a good public service and don't let that deteriorate, people will realize, hey, we can economize, we can find ways to regionalize or even consolidate or at least share a service with another town or school board and still maintain our community and neighborhood character that is part and parcel of why we love New Jersey.
Senator, thanks so much for joining
great.
Us today.
To
Lots of
you.
Great stuff.
Thank
Good to see
much.
You as always.
Okay.
Coming up next, county leaders will weigh in on shared services. Stay tuned.